One of the most striking thing is that when you come to a health center in a remote area is that you see that there is no patients there. And you go into the health center and you understand why. The fridge has no vaccines, either because the fridge is not working or because the delivery has never come, because it's such a difficult way to get there.
They don't put it on the whole month because they have to pay for the petrol often themselves. So they limit it to 3 or 4 days during the month that they put on the fridge. And once their two or three days of vaccinations are over, they put it off back off again.
The system is going through an agony of change at the moment. The reason is that up till now, the vaccines have actually been a very small volume. Really, comparatively speaking, we're talking about 1 or 2 or 3 cold rooms for a medium-sized country, 30 million people or something. The new vaccines which are arriving are driving up the volume of vaccines that we're handling by rather a lot, something up to 4 times.
It was just a discussion over a glass of beer in Geneva, and I said, okay, we'll do it. I think at the end of the day, it is the vaccine manufacturers are in a vaccine business to make profit. Nobody wants to make losses and make the products, right? So if they feel that the profits are not going to come by developing a product for a developing country, then naturally there will be hesitation. If all the procurement agencies, if they can come together along with the international agencies like Gavi or maybe the Gates Foundation, and give an assurance to the manufacturers about the quantities that they are going to buy and the time period for which they will buy. Because unless there is a sustainability and a guarantee of purchase, I think manufacturers will not feel comfortable.
It's a frustrating thing when you see that a measles vaccination that is so easy to give and should have been just such a normal thing for all children to have, that you see that because of rupture of cold chain or rupture of administration, that children are dying for something that could so much be prevented.
Gavi can do very simple things like shifting the market towards products that are more adaptable to field needs. That's very obvious, that's very simple. But it can also design its policies around that and not necessarily just look at price as an indicator, but adaptability as a key point.